Hello everyone, my name is Sachin Bhogal, Assistant Professor Chitkara College of Hospitality Management. So today we are going to discuss about the Menu Engineering Part 2. Okay, so before starting the topic, I just want to share one quote which I have just read about this Menu Engineering. So capturing the attention of your customer is vitally important and is the foundation principle of the Menu Engineering. Alright, so that is why I have chosen the topic Menu Engineering, because this is something which is intriguing me to discuss what makes your menu work hard. Okay, so the first thing which is which you can see on the slide is, where do eyes first look on the restaurant menu? Okay, so with this note, let's discuss the what are the different objectives of this topic. So in this topic, student shall know the importance of placement of dishes on the menu card. The student shall know how to improve the quality of the menu so that your menu starts working automatically for the selling of your dishes instead of you are doing for your restaurant. So that is something which I am sure that at the end of the session, student will be able to explain, right? So before starting, just wanted to confirm and wanted to make sure that, you know, you guys must have watched my previous video in which we had discussed about the different categories of the menu, because that is the base of this topic. If you have not or if you had not got a chance to watch that video yet, so please, my request is, go and watch that video, so that this will help you to get the better understanding of this particular topic. Okay, in which we are going to discuss about the placement of the different dishes in the menu, that how you know, placement of the dishes in a menu plays a very important role for the upselling of a restaurant. So let's start. So you must have heard this thing before, that, you know, there are four boxes on the basis of which the menu is being classified. Okay, and we had already discussed, so one is stars, plow horses, puzzles and dogs. Okay, so in terms of the in the perspective of the menu, if you want to talk or if you want to distinguish these categories, then stars are those items which are very much popular, you know, and of course very much profitable. So these are that might be probably the reason that these items are called star items. The another one is puzzles, again, which are very profitable, okay, but again not very popular. Third one is plow horses, which are very popular but not very much profitable. The fourth one is dogs, which are not profitable nor popular, right? So if you can see the focal point on the slide, okay, I have intentionally placed these categories on a strategic location. Okay, so for example, if you can see on the extreme top right, I have placed stars, then extreme left on the top, plow horses, below that dogs, and on the below on the beside of the dogs, there are puzzles. So if you notice, okay, or if you have ever observed, or from the next time whenever you go to the restaurant, you will observe that restaurant's menu plays very much important role for in the psychology of your choosing of the dishes. For example, if you can see, if you can see on this slide, there are four categories which have been placed on the menu. So on the extreme top right, you can see the star items. And then extreme left on the top are your plow horses. Puzzles is something which is beneath the stars, and beside the puzzles you can see the dogs. So this is the case when the focal point is when you have the two leaf menu. So once, if you can imagine, if you can visualize, you are holding a menu in your hand which has two leaves. So the moment you will open the menu, the first focal point which you will see, or the first the first sight you will give on the menu is on the extreme top of the menu. So there is the place where most of the people place the dishes which are very much popular and very much profitable, so which are stars basically, right? So if we talk about the different panels, okay, for example, if there is a panel which has only one sheet of one panel menu, so the focal point is on the top of the menu. So if we talk about the two panel, then extreme right on the top is the focal point. Then again three panel or fourth panel is again similar on the right top or extreme left. Okay, that is the reason that, you know, most of the dishes which are very much popular or very much profitable, or if we talk about the profitability, they are always placed on these particular places, right? So now the question which should come, that how we should know that what can be done. So for example, if there is a star item which is very much popular and very much profitable, so if I will continue with the same practice of placing those star items on the extreme on the extreme right top, then probably over the period of time the plow horses, which are very much less in the profitability, and the dogs will start vanishing from my menu. So again, that is something which I don't want, because plow horses are something which are giving the popularity for your restaurant, because those are the dishes which are very popular but not as profitable. Okay, so now in this particular topic, or in this particular topic, we will discuss about the how you improve your menu and how you can manage the different categories of the menu. For example, how you can manage the plow horses. So plow horses is something which is very much popular but not profitable. This is the definition of the plow horses in the context of the menu, right? So number one point, or number one thing which you can do regarding the plow horses, you can reallocate the items to a row profile of the menu. Okay, since these are the popular dishes, so of course guest will be able to find these dishes anywhere in the menu. So you this is something which is very, very tricky or very touchy you can do with the menu. So you can reallocate the dishes from one place to another place. Okay, the another thing which you can do to add the to improve the plow horses, you can you can start adding on the values, or you can start giving the add-ons with the plow horses. For example, offering a larger portion size, okay, more compliments, okay, or better quality ingredients and garnishing may add value to the item. So people started spending more on the plow horses, because plow horses is something which is popular. Is popularity is something which is the strength of these dishes. So popularity, we need to convert those popularity into profitability also. So by adding these small steps, you can do the big changes in the plow horses. Now managing plow stars, star is something which you can't do much, because you can only do the only thing which you can do, you can make a rigid specification. Okay, do not try to alter the quality of the product. Okay, always placed in the high visible area, because this is something which is very much popular and very much profitable, right? Number three is puzzles, which is again very much important. Okay, take them out of the menu. Okay, wait, not in that way. Particular puzzles are something which is very low in popularity but very high in the profitability. So those dishes, okay, which are having very high cost, okay, because since it is something which is only contributing the profitability part but not helping you to make your restaurant more popular, so the dishes which are having very high cost, you can remove from the menu, right? And then you can try again adding value to the item through the table d'hote table. Okay, converting those a la carte dishes into table d'hote dishes, so that is something which might make them, or which will make them, more profitable, right? Number four is how you can manage dogs. So dogs are something which are very low profitable and very low popular. So number one thing which you can do, slowly started removing these dishes from the menu, right? Otherwise, when a dog involves a significant labor cost, you know, and not very popular or not very profit oriented, then you know it is better to removal of the menu is one option. Otherwise, by changing the recipe or by changing the presentation of that particular dish, maybe that can add value to the menu. So that is something which you can do with the improvement of your menu. Okay, so with this note, these are the few basic principles, or these are the few basic points which you can keep in your mind while you will improve the menu. Okay, on the basis of which you can strategically place the different items in the menu, right? So with this note, thank you very much once again. Stay safe till the time we meet again. Thank you.